Hey, what's up guys, it's Tech Mayor. Thanks for tuning in. Today I'll be reviewing the Galaxy Note 10 and Note 10 Plus, which was announced and released the same month, August 2019. It also has a 5G version, which I'm not sure is available in every country. Before we get into the video, I would like you to click the subscribe button and also the notification bell so you can get notified when I post new videos. Appearance, they say, matters a lot, and the Samsung Galaxy Note 10 and Note 10 Plus did not disappoint. The Note 10 and the Note 10 Plus has an Infinity O display, a Gorilla Glass 6 on the front and back of the phone, which blends with the aluminum frame. Trust me, it feels premium and very expensive. It has a punch hole camera right on the top middle part of the screen, and you're left with a 6.3 inch dynamic AMOLED touchscreen, having a 90.9% screen to body ratio with a resolution of 1080 by 2290 pixels and 401 ppi density. And the Plus version has 6.8 inch dynamic AMOLED touchscreen with 91.0% screen to body ratio and a resolution of 1440 by 3040 pixels. That is a ppi density of 498. Due to the bigger screen, and they both have always on display. They both have their volume rocker and power / big speed button on the left. The SIM card tray is on top of the device. On the Note 10, we have a dual SIM non-expandable. Then on the Note 10 Plus, we have an hybrid SIM card tray where you can choose to expand your memory or use a dual SIM card. On the bottom of the device, they both have a Type-C USB port for fast charging. Still on the bottom, we have the stereo speakers having Dolby Atmos and the AKG sound and an active noise cancellation microphone. Sorry to disappoint you, but it doesn't have a 3.5mm headphone jack, and this is done for a good reason. I think the tech world is turning into a wireless space, and also I think it will boost the sales of the Galaxy Buds, which by the way has great sound. Then on the back of the device, we have of course the Samsung logo and the three camera setup. The first is a 12 megapixel camera with a focal length of 1.5 to 2.4 and a 27 millimeter wide angle lens. It has dual pixel PDAF and an optical image stabilization, that's the OIS. The second is a 12 megapixel camera, a focal length of 2.1, 52mm telephoto lens, PDAF, optical image stabilization, and a 2x optical zoom. And lastly, we have the 16 megapixel, a focal length of 2.2, a 12mm ultra wide lens, a LED flash, auto HDR, a panorama on both devices. While the Note 10 Plus has an additional depth vision camera, which makes a 3D image come to life. All you need to do is to take a 3D picture of the image, which you can print via a 3D printer or just have fun with it. In summary, the Note 10 and Note 10 Plus has the wide angle lens, the telephoto lens, and the ultra wide lens. The Note 10 and Note 10 Plus shoots videos in three different resolutions. First one is 2160p at 30 frames/60 frames per second. You can either choose to use the 30 frames or the 60 frames. And the second one is 1080p by 30, 60 or 240 frames per second. That's, you can either choose to use the 30 frames, the 60 frames or the 240 frames per second. Lastly, we have the 720/960 frames per second with HDR10+. The cameras on this device is a pro-grade camera and has a dual video recording feature, a bokeh video effect, as you can blur the background and just have you there, a stereo sound recording. It also has the gyro EIS and the OIS, that's the optical image stabilization, for super steady video. The Note 10 and Note 10 Plus also has a feature called the AR Dodo. This option is found on the top left corner of the camera setup. Now, while shooting a video, the AR, that's augmented reality, uses a Snapchat-like feature, but here, what you get to do is you draw and write whatever you want on the face using the back camera. Your drawing and writing moves with the person's face. It goes away when you close your face, and I personally like this feature, and I'm sure most bloggers and vloggers would like it too. The front-facing punch hole camera is a 10 megapixel camera with a focal length of 2.2. It's a 26 millimeter wide angle lens. Now, it allows you to take pictures, like cover more areas when taking pictures. It is capable of recording videos at 2160p at 30 frames per second and 1080p at 30 frames per second with auto HDR. The Galaxy Note 10 and Note 10 Plus is premium, not just because of its look, but also because it feels premium. The device is 151mm tall, 71.8mm wide and 7.9mm thick, weighing 168, while the Plus version is 162.3mm long, 77.2mm wide and 7 7.9 millimeter thick, weighing 196 grams. To give you a better user experience, Samsung installed on the Note 10 and Note 10 Plus a 7 nanometer Qualcomm SDM855, Snapdragon 855, only for those in the US and China, while every other country gets through the same 7 nanometer Exynos 9825. The device has an octa-core 2x 2.73 GHz Mongoose M4, 2x 2.4 GHz Cortex A75, and lastly 4x.19 GHz Cortex A55 CPU, and the Mali G76 MP12 GPU for those in other countries, and those in the US and China get an Adreno 640 GPU. The Note 10 has 8GB of RAM, a 256GB of storage, and is not expandable, but the Note 10 Plus has 12GB of RAM, an option of 256 or 512 of storage, and it is expandable up to 1TB using a micro SD card. All of this powers the Android 9 Pie and the Samsung One UI. The 4300mAh battery of the Note 10 Plus lasts an average of 11 hours and 9 minutes on the web surfing battery test, which is excellent, while the Note 10 has a 3500mAh battery. They are both non-removable. They both have the reversed wireless charging, meaning you can charge another device with the Note 10 or the Note 10 Plus. Both device comes with a 25-watt fast charger out of the box, which charges the phone to 65% in 30 minutes and 33% in 15 minutes. And you can also get an optional 40-watt super fast charger, which will charge your phone up to 100% in 30 minutes. Also, the Note 10 and Note 10 Plus support fast wireless charging 2.0. The Note 10 and Note 10 Plus comes in 6 colors. We have the Aura Glow, which creates beautiful colors by refracting light, the Aura White, the Aura Black, the Aura Pink, the Aura Red, and the Aura Blue, which is only available on the 5G version, and you can only get that from the Samsung website. As mentioned earlier, the Note 10 has no headphone jack, also no physical fingerprint sensor. This time, Samsung embedded the fingerprint under the display. This is called ultrasonic fingerprint sensor, and believe me, it is fast and better in terms of accuracy than the capacitive and the optical fingerprint sensor. The Note 10 and Note 10 Plus both have Bluetooth 5.0, one of the best speakers on the market, and the Samsung DeX, that's to give you the desktop experience. They also have NFC, Samsung Pay, and you don't get infrared for remote control anymore. You do not have to worry about the water or the dust getting inside the device. It is IP68 water and dust proof, meaning you can submerge it to 1.5 meters into fresh water for 30 minutes. What makes the Note series unique is the trademark S Pen. It obviously can write, take notes without unlocking your phone with the screen off memo feature. On the Note 10 and Note 10 Plus, we have an even more intelligent S Pen. It turns your writing into text, highlights your text easily. It has a Bluetooth accelerometer and 6-axis gyro sensor, which allows you to take pictures and control your phone with the motion tracking feature without having to touch your phone at all. Amazing, right? The colors are even more better than last year's yellow. We have the blue S Pen for the Aura Glow, a glossy black S Pen for the Aura Black, a silver white S Pen for the Aura White, a glossy red S Pen for the Aura Red, and a glossy pink for the Aura Pink. Comparing the performance of the Samsung Note 10 Plus to the iPhone XS Max, the Note 10 loses to the iPhone XS Max in the single and multi-core. The difference between the performance is clear. The iPhone leads in computing, but the Note 10 leads in GPU score on the 3D Mac. If you're a gamer, I would advise you go for the Note 10 Plus because it has a bigger RAM and higher graphics. The pricing, and this is one factor majority consider before getting a device. The Note 10 in Nigeria is priced at 330,500 on Jumia with free Galaxy Buds. On Glow Outlets, the same price, also free Galaxy Buds and free screen repair, both with Samsung Care of 1 year warranty. The Note 10 is $950 in the US. In India, it's priced at 36,999 rupee. The Note 10 Plus in Nigeria is priced 384,000 for the 12GB RAM and the 256GB of space on Jumia with the free Galaxy Buds, and on Glow Outlets, it also comes with the free Galaxy Buds and the free screen repair and the Samsung Care of 1 year both. Now in the US, you can get it from Amazon at $1,099 for the 256GB version, $1,199 for the 512 version. In India, it's priced at 79,999 rupee. Okay, now this is the price, and it depends on your pocket and the reason why you're getting the phone. So I think you should be, I think at this point you should be able to decide if you're stepping up or you're sticking to your previous Galaxy Notes. Thank you for watching this video. Kindly subscribe in case you forget to do so at the beginning of the video. And don't forget to hit the like button and drop any suggestions or opinion in the comment section. And I'll see you in the next video.